So a Steam guide was sent to me by Avi Thor, explaining how to fix stuttering and input lag for CSGO. This video is sponsored by CS Money. Trade your skins fast and easy, it's safe to use, and it includes a balance system for more skins. You can also buy skins now on the site, check it out, the link is in the video description. Hey guys, salut mes amis, och hallo gebar. Maxime here. So VIT, or VIT, made a Steam guide explaining what you can do if you have high FPS, but you're still experiencing performance issues. The first solution he had was the one I was interested in, so that's the one I'm gonna focus on in this video. I decided to test it out, and honestly, as soon as I started the game and joined a retake server, boom. It was almost like my mouse felt much more responsive somehow, and the movement was more smooth. Now the problem is, I'm not 100% sure what it did, or if it's just an illusion, but the response seems very positive. So making a video about it didn't feel totally unnecessary. Here's what you do, start by exiting CSGO. Now download the Nvidia Profile Inspector from the link below. Don't worry, it's not a virus. Create a folder somewhere on your computer where you can pull all the files, and start the program. Inside the program, choose Counter-Strike Global Offensive. You can type it in as well, it's much faster. In the second section called Sync and Refresh, there's a setting called Frame Rate Limiter Mode. It's probably set to just default. According to the guide, change it to this. And if that doesn't work, change it to this. I decided to keep it on the first option. After that, click Apply Changes, and that's it. Now join a server and see if you can feel any difference.
But Maximo, what about your FPS?
Keep in mind, this guide has nothing to do with boosting your FPS. However, I still wanted to compare my FPS, so I ran the FPS benchmark map, which you can find below, and my FPS had basically not changed. Once again, this guide is not about boosting your FPS, but remove stuttering and input lag. If you don't like the tweak, or if it feels worse, you can simply change it back to the setting it had, probably default. Oh, and I don't know any technical details about this setting or why this seems to work well. I'm only sharing it with you guys. And you know that I like to make these types of videos. There was also a second tweak mentioned in the guide, but changing things in the registry can break some features in Windows, especially here with networking related services, so I wouldn't recommend it. Let me know if you've tried this out and if it helped. Make sure you credit the guy who made the guide. I'll link it down below. Hope you enjoyed the video. You can follow me on my social medias to see what's going on behind the scenes. I'll see you guys in the next one, and go bananas.